and welcome to the University of Bradford's Biological Anthropology Research Centre. My name is Dr. Shirley Curtis-Summers, and I just want to give you a very brief tour of our facilities here. So we have a number of labs dedicated to the study and research on human remains, whether that is a student or a visiting researcher. But what I want to show you today is our dedicated lab to the study of ancient human remains. So what we have here is, firstly, a number of casts, and they're used for teaching, for example, biological anthropology. So we have early hominids, early modern humans, primates, old world monkeys, so on and so forth. So these casts are fantastic to be able to learn about early modern right through to forensic studies. Okay. So if we go into the Keith Manchester lab, and this is where we do the majority of teaching on human osteology and paleopathology. Come on in. And I'd like to welcome you to two of our osteologists. We have Meg, who actually did our undergraduate forensic archaeology and anthropology, and thankfully staying with us to do a master's in human osteology and paleopathology. And we also have Georgia, who also did her master's in human osteology and paleopathology, and thankfully staying on with us to do a PhD. So once you come here, you cannot leave. So Meg, would you like to just give us a brief understanding of what you're looking at there?
Yeah, no problem. So just from doing a really quick visual assessment, I've determined that this is an adult male. I'd say that he was a pretty robust male when he was alive. So I've had a look at these arm bones here, and we can see there's a really rugged muscle attachment point here for the deltoid, so just this bit here. So he would have been a pretty muscular chap in life. I'll pass over to Georgia.
Fantastic, thanks Meg. As you can see, we have a range of resources from x-rays to plastic casts to real human remains. So Georgia, would you like to explain what you're looking at there?
Much like Meg, I have determined that this is an adult male, also quite robust. However, there are three very clear healed rib fractures. And if I just lift this up, you can see how well that has healed.
Thanks guys. Right, so while they're hard at work, I'm just going to show you some pathology casts. Again, these are used for teaching students all about the effects of disease and trauma on bone. So some of these are real and some of these are actual replicas. So you will get to handle both. So just to quickly run through, we have, for example, evidence of trauma here, and this is in the form of a sharp blade wound to the back of the top of the neck. So this is actually a decapitation. So that normally would be that, and it's being cut away. So that is this bone at the very top. So this would have been cut, sliced through, and that is evidence of decapitation. And then we have evidence of a very ancient surgical procedure known as trepanation. So these three specimens are on the top of the skull, and you can see here these holes. And these are all evidence of either unhealed or healed trepanation, where they would drill into the skull or cut into the skull for whatever reason, from fractured skull through to releasing evil spirits. Then we have a range of pathology here in the form of sharp force trauma, so a blade wound across the top of the head. This is an infectious disease known as venereal syphilis. So this has caused severe changes to the top of the skull. And this is a gunshot wound, again, to the top of the skull here, and this is unhealed. And you'll learn all about the effects of healing of bone due to disease or trauma. Then we have the upper arm bone. This is the humerus, okay? So that is a normal humerus. As you can see here from these two, this is evidence of a gunshot wound again, okay? So a number of fractures and shattered bone around there. And this is a amputated humerus. So you can see the end there is healed. And this would have been amputated halfway down the arm there. And then a range of other forms of pathology, from fractures. This is the lower leg, the tibia. This is how the tibia should look. And this is the fracture. So that's the normal, and that is the fractured bone. And then we can see some severe changes to bone due to nutritional diseases. For example, rickets. Okay, so rickets is a vitamin D deficiency. And this is the lower leg bone, and you can see it's severely misshapen. And then amputation again. So looking at the same tibia and fibula here, however, here we have evidence of an amputation with severe secondary infection around it. So that individual did not heal very well from that amputation. Then again, severe fractures, such as this femur. So that's your normal femur, and that is quite a nasty fracture, as you can see. However, it healed at the time, so this individual would have survived after that trauma, which is quite horrific trauma. And then if we come down to a pathology that was very prevalent in the past, but is still very prevalent today, which is osteoarthritis. So this is, you can see that polishing with a bone-on-bone effect. That is osteoarthritis of the hip. And as I say, that is still very prevalent today. So we not only learn about diseases from ancient human remains, but they're also very useful to help us understand modern diseases as well. So finally, if I just take you through to our bone store, and this is where we house all our skeletal remains. So here at Bark, we have one of the largest skeletal collections in the country. I think it's currently around 5,000 skeletons. And these range from the Bronze Age right through to the post-medieval period. So it's a fantastic teaching resource that we have. So if you come here at the University of Bradford, you will have access to ancient human remains from a wealth of different sites across the country. Okay, this is a controlled environment, so we adhere to really, really strict and high quality procedures and handling of our human remains. And we also have, down the bottom, we have an X-ray facility, and we have research labs as well for dedicated postgraduate teaching and research. Okay, so that is a quick tour of Bark. Look forward to welcoming you in the near future. Bye.